Hi, Siva. Question for you. A lot of people who have learnt a Chow guy in the past, now they've tried to add other Kung Fu to the Chow guy. Some people add Tai Chi.
Yeah.
Some people add, who knows, different systems, you know, maybe wrestling or maybe, I've heard of one person who added cotton palm. I've never heard of this. So Chow Ga doesn't need this.
Of course, Chow Ga is Chow Ga. Chow Ga used to be a practice to the pure Chow Ga. If you mix another Kung Fu or another Qi Gong to Chow Ga, it's very, very long. It's very not good for your training the Chow Ga. Because some Kung Fu is very soft. When he uses the soft Kung Fu, soft manner to training the Chow Ga, but no good. You make Chow Ga very, very most soft. But if your joint and the Kung Fu is very strong, very hard, but it's also not very good for Chow Ga training. Because Chow Ga training, all the Kung Fu is the sometimes soft, sometimes hard, soft, hard, soft, hard. We change immediately, very quick. We don't need to do soft, soft too much, and don't need to do hard, hard, hard always like that. No, we can do it according such your fighting condition. Under your condition, you sometimes you quite use soft, sometimes you quite use the hard. So that if you use the other soft and hard Kung Fu, put it into Chow Ga, then your Kung Fu is not very good.
So why would they add that to Chow Ga? Do you have any idea?
Or maybe they don't know if he is a Chow Ga Sifu. If he put those Kung Fu, soft or hard Kung Fu to Chow Ga, he means he doesn't know the real important thing of Chow Ga is the certainly hard, certainly soft. They don't know. They don't know. They have also have low method to train it by that, because our Chow Ga, the highest Kung Fu is most immediately soft and immediately soft and hard and soft. It changes very, very quick. When we are training, we do that. And we are fighting also do that. If you are fighting, you always soft, it's no use. Because for my experience, from 1969, I start holding a school from past master Ipsoy. Yeah, from that time to nowadays, I still carry on Ipsoy's Kung Fu. Because I training all the time is according to Ipsoy's mind and Ipsoy's what he has said.
His method, Siva. His method.
Yes, his method. Yeah. I use his method. I train him all day.
The relationship with Qi Gong and Chow Ga, are they related in any way?
I can say truly 100% the other Qi Gong of Chow Ga outside, not completely 100% complete from Ipsoy. Because when too many people, even they allow is the Chow Ga Sifu, but they when during the time he follow Ipsoy, Ipsoy is getting old at that time, an old man. Even me, maybe later, I'm old. I will forget too many Kung Fu. The old man, his memory is not no good. So at that time, at the late time, they follow Ipsoy. They learn the Kung Fu always. It's Ipsoy teach him, but too many Kung Fu is, change too much. But I follow Ipsoy. When Ipsoy is still very young, very powerful, his Yes, Kung Fu is very most powerful. He's very young. I follow you, sir. The time is a lot more than 50 years. He's still very young. A very good Kung Fu teacher. So that I can get his the important Kung Fu and the highest Kung Fu at the very, very early. Because Yip Sui is my father-in-law. When my first student born, Yip Sui teach me Yong Sang Gong, the whole form of Yong Sang Gong. The whole form of Yong Sang Gong, you may train it. The first result is you have your good health here. Yeah? And then your body can, just like a gum bong, it means that you can anti the heating. And then you are when you are fighting, all the exercise most amazing. I mean, they're very quick, very fast, just like that. And then later, you have the result to your testicle can get up.
Testicle, Ziba.
Your testicle.
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 Yeah. Can put in your body, and then you can the others take you just like matter during your fighting.
And that's from learning Yuan Shan Gong properly.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. If no properly, you just training just one style or one action or two action.
One section.
One section. No use. You should be from the beginning to the end. When every time when I lead them training the Yuan Shan Gong, always 1 hour, at least 1 hour.
1 hour.
Yeah. There the form. Carry on, non-stop, from beginning to the last.
So it's
last
a very long form.
Yeah. Very long form.
That's the short version.
Yeah, 1 hour.
Yeah, 1 hour, at least 1 hour. Sometimes 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Yeah.
That's according to our students' standard. If their standard is more good, I make it to 1 hour and 30. 1 hour 30.
Yeah. And are there different standards?
Yeah, up to your standard.
So 1, 2, and three.
Yeah.
There's three levels.
Yeah, three levels.
Oh, that's
a big one. If a Chaga practitioner doesn't have Yuan Shan Gong, the power can only go to a certain level?
No Yuan Shan Gong, you never can get to the up person.
You'd have to use weights or something.
You waste your time.
Dumbbell Lick Wong.
No. Dung Gong Li Wong, also is only the form. His power is a big distance from to the Yong Sang Gong.
Yeah.
Yong Sang Gong is the first one, the highest one.
Maybe that's the reason that some people do other things.
I got plenty of students. He have learned the Yong Sang Gong. He can also take test ball. You have the internet, you can see too many students. But the other Zhouga teacher, they can't do that except Yip Ji, the son of Yip Sui. Because Yip Ji is my brother-in-law, I'm the eldest. My wife is the eldest sister. So I am the stronger way. So that I can train him. Many students can take. He can't. It's just himself, no student.